Hello, everybody. Welcome to a new little game that I've decided to download and play. The thing that's cool about this is that Mux, you mentioned about playing pool or playing snooker a little bit earlier, and well, this is what this game is. What will we do? Let's go in and see if we can run a game. We'll have a quick game. Of fancy a game of snooker, actually. We will play amateur. And off we'll go searching for an opponent, which I'm not sure if there's any opponents online right now, but we will play against DNA instead. So the DNA thing in this game, this is called Pure Pool by Vufu Studios. It's aimed at kind of characterizing your game style, and then we're playing against Mojo. Mojo is level 22. I am not level 22. I am basically level 2 or something, so I'm not very good, but it looks like I've won the toss, so I'm going to play. I'm using an Xbox controller, and with that, we have the ability to basically strike the ball with the cue and move around and things. So here we go. This is my break, which isn't fantastic. And now DNA Mojo is on, looking to see what he's going to go for. And ooh, jarred that one in the jaw. I am not very good at this game. I should start that very much as a statement of intention. I am going to do a cannon shot here, and there is a cheat going on. And that cheat is that at the amateur level, you do get this helper to tell you how your angles work, and I don't know how to turn it off yet. And I haven't tried too hard to turn it off. But anyway, I think that's going to be a good one. So, and I hit that too hard. The little analog sticks on the Xbox game controller are what I'm using here, and there's a really good sense. It's been coded very well. There's a strong sense of control. You do get a that's a foul. You do get a sense of power, and they put it the wrong ball, but I'm going to play on. And we are up next, and hopefully I'm going to be able to get in on this one here and see if we can actually put this one into the pocket. Making a kind of a judgment there. Oh, that was a miscue by me. That was a good angle as well, and I've just given him the shot, although he's chosen to try and pinch this one into the corner, which he's managed to get in. So as a result of that, me talking about controlling the controller, I've shown you how to mess up with the controller. And I don't know why he's choosing to put this in like this, but it didn't work for him. It was a good effort, and that pocket is looking like it's. No, it's not. Is it? I might be able to sneak that in. I might be able to sneak that in. Although I don't think I will. No, let's quickly move around here and see what else we have on offer. We can try to put this one down into the corner. If I hold this button down, I get this cue view that's down here. And if I press the X button, then I stand up and I can have a look. This is going to be unlucky shot if I make it, but I did make it, and that puts me on for the black, which I hope I'll be able to put in, and then see what we'll do. If I hold down the A button, I can then use the left stick just to control the aim, and then it's a case of just bringing back the cue enough to actually get the ball in. I don't know what the system is choosing to, make the next ball choice for. It seems to just pick some random ball on the table. And you can see that from this perspective, this is relatively easy to start putting. You see, it goes for the blue up there. I don't know why it does that. Let me see. Now this helper is good, but it only gives you so much health, and then you have to kind of make the judgment yourself. So that went in, and we're coming back down. Now, I watched a lot of snooker on TV, and I've played only a little bit of snooker once in a while. Ah, not good, not good. I've let him back in, and he's aiming for what? One of these he's aiming for. Now, he's not using any apparent aids where I am, and I'm sure I'll learn how to turn those off sooner or later. But right now I'm going to enjoy using them for the purpose of this. I didn't really do what I wanted to do there, actually. I could have used a little bit of... is there any way in which I can get that to go in? No. Let's go for a long one. This is the blue. So what does that look like? Into the corner. Now this is making it up as you go along, so... I might have to try and force this red here now. I'm wondering if it'll go. Make a bit of an effort to punch it in. And pull the other one out. So that's not too bad. Not terribly bad. The green is just asking to get put back on its spot. And that red will drop behind me so that I can come on back a little bit further now. Come on. This red is possibly going to go in there. This is a risk shot. What other alternatives do I have? Got that long red that can go down there. No. I'm actually going to pop the white. Foul ball. Brilliant. Excellent. Stupid. But anyway, you get that. This is how the game goes. I made a break of 10 points. So, yeah, we're fairly amateur here. He's thrown that opportunity away, and he's presented me with one. If we can just put the brakes on that cue ball now, come on around here, we can take one out. Now, if I wanted to screw this back a little bit, I would hold the B button down, and then I would drop down here, and that will give me a little bit of spin of some design, which is not the spin I wanted, by the way. Not the spin that I wanted at all. That might bring those two into play. If that actually will go in. Ugh. Middle pockets. The nemesis of moi. Okay, so he's going to try and pinch this one in, is he? And he's able to do that. Not too bad at all. Now, over the course of me playing more games, my DNA mojo, or DNA whatever, it will build up a kind of a similar characteristic to my gameplay. So it'll kind of make the shots that I'm making, and it'll make the mistakes that I'm making, and therefore it'll kind of give me a bit of a challenge, which is at least equivalent to the latest information that represents my gameplay. And then, after that, we don't know. I guess it's constantly adjusting. So if I was to do a triple cannon here for fun, that would send that way, which would hit that one in there, which would, I think that would work quite well. Or not. Oh no, not another foul ball. Excellent. Well, 8 of his 18 points have been donated through my kindness. The opponent did decide to play on, which is very nice. And he's choosing to put that one in. Okay. And that's going to bring him up for a black in, which is going to bring him up to 26 points or 8 on this break. Or he's going to go for the blue. Okay. You could do that too. And what have we got on here? Not a lot on that. I don't really like my chances. This here is not a lot, and the black is down there getting in the way for that. So, trying to play a snooker here if I was any good. Just put a lot of spin on it. I don't know if this is the right spin. And then get that up there and see if that's a snooker, which it isn't at all. And he still goes for this one that she's able to put in. 32 plays 21. He's on a break of one and he's going for the blue, which he should be able to put in. Now he's after going to go down the table. And there's three more reds, so potentially 24 points there plus the colors. Ooh, that was a bit good. What's he going to take out here? Blue or brown? Pink. 32 plays 32. It's going to be a terrible game for me if this continues. And now he does this funky shot, which is pretty impressive. Now he needs to. That's a straight in. Huh. Well, that's kind of something like I would have done. We'll play on because what else have we got to do? This is where we move the ball, press yellow to set it in, and then we're just going to knock that one down there. Oh, you didn't. Now he'll make this surely. And just kind of spin it around. He missed. No ball was hit. I'll play on. See if we can take advantage of this situation here. We'll just poke this one ever so gently. That was almost a little bit too gently. Almost to the point that I nearly didn't get it in. No, no, no. I think our shot makes it for blue or pink. I think pink might actually work. Get to there. And then just kind of go gentle. And then we have to go up for the yellow, which I'm not going to be able to make very well. But we could try and slice it in, I suppose. Or not. And we just set up the yellow so that it's on for him. Come on past the pocket. Well, it'll do. He does this funky thing. I don't know what this movement is, but it didn't pay off and it set me up. So, gently does it now. And now if I was a better player, I'd be able to put a little bit of spin so that I would bring the cue ball back for that green. But I actually don't know how to do that. But we'll try. Come on, a little bit more. No, that didn't work at all, unfortunately. Now, what are the odds of making this shot count? No. No. Bloody hell. Know your angles. Know your angles. Right, the green is behind the line, so he could force me to What's he doing? He's decided to play on. Of course, this is golf. Or this is not golf. This is snooker. I knew that, and he's going to follow that in, surely? No. He's a little bit compromised for his brown now. Although, not so compromised that he can't get to it. I'm just wondering, will he be able to pocket it? That answer is a very strong yes. Now, what's he going to do with his blue? The black is controlling that. Unbelievable. We need him to miss now, otherwise we're going to lose this game. This is not going so well. 55 plays. 51. Ooh. Keep going back. Do I go for it, or do I kind of go for an opportunity to play safe? I don't know how to play safe enough. Let's go for it. Well, he's got this in, surely. There's no way that he's going to not be able to make this shot. Now he does his funky thing again. Oh, this is a set piece. So this is the end of it for me. Nice. Does these little cinematic little bits and pieces as well. So I've lost the game. This is my DNA Mojo's picture. It's a bit disturbing. I'm a rookie, and I took him down to the black, which suggests that his 22 level of talent is some... Well, there's room for improvement, perhaps. But this is the game. This is how it's set up. This is a view from standing up of the table. The quality of the the graphics, excuse me, the shine, the clarity on the balls, the pool cue, the sounds, the ambience. It's all pretty good, actually. And it's also this is a practice session now, so I can. You know, I can get myself organized and plan some practice that's going in. This is something, obviously, I desperately need to do lots of. Otherwise, we won't be getting very much in the way of success on this game. But there is a really strong sense of playing the game with a cue, and you're not playing the game with a cue at all, which is a very strange bit. I do get a sense from the sounds and the apparent feedback that there's I do need to practice all of those, don't I, badly. There's a real sense that, you know, you can actually cue quite well in this game. Judgment of angles and things, well, that's the whole principle of the game all over, I suppose, and that is clearly not something that I've gotten a very strong hold on just yet. Red's going to foul my shot on the pink, I think. Or is it? Oh no, this is a middle one now again. Let's see if I got that one in. I did. Tactics, which ball to choose next, how to properly take a shot, how to work away at a table, building up a break, all of those kind of skills. I don't know anything about them yet. I'll learn, I'm sure. But I'll have to make lots of mistakes first. And for folks that are... I would say that's about it, is it? No. Learning the angles, you know, learning the gameplay is one aspect, and then building up a degree of consistency. Well, that's the whole challenge of snooker anyway, isn't it? That's a gentle one there. Would that go in? No, just kiss the corner. And this one is another test one to do between here and here. That's going to run down there and go in, as it is. Good. And then I can see if I can take the black into the corner there, which will be the next challenge. Hit A and you'll be able to just fine control that. Nope. Close, but no cigar, and we're off the cushion here. Long putts. Let's see if we can. No, we don't. We only have that red. A couple of reds down there that are open to us. Let's try this one a little bit more. You can hear the sounds as it bounces off the cushion. The sound of the cue hitting the ball, the balls hitting each other. It's all very realistic. Now, I don't want to follow this one in, do I? So let's put a bit of spin on here. Whoa! How much is that? Okay, that's all part of the education as well. Now I should be able to just poke this one with a little gentle persuasion, and that'll set me up for the black. But you see, this is the practice game, so that black will go in there then with a gentle nod, and I didn't hit it nearly hard enough. Really, really bad. This is. You can get very gentle, and then you can just send everything in behind it. It's about, like any game, getting a feel for it, isn't it? Come on, come on, come on. That'll do. I'm not really doing very much to control the cue ball here, am I? I'm kind of just hitting balls. That's the next one. It's a very amateur way of playing the game. I'm going to go for this one because it's a corner, it's a center pocket, and it's usually a little bit more of a challenge. And gentle does it, so. No. So anyway, this is a practice game. You can also play pool. I'll bring you over to the pool table now in a minute. In fact, let's go over to the pool table now. I don't need to do any more there. If we go to my games, and we go in here and go to a quick game, then we can go to 8-ball or 9-ball pool. I'll play 9-ball pool, and we'll do it as an amateur. We're waiting for an opponent again. Now, I don't know who my opponents are. I don't know if... I guess there is online here as well, or private room, and I'm okay to play on a private room, but... here we leave the snooker hole, and we pass through this rather plush thing, hopping over the desk here, and here's the pool. And we can move this around to suit ourselves, and then that is the start, which is a big punch. Now, I don't know the rules of this game of pool, so I'm just going to aim for whichever ball I'm being pointed at. You'll notice that there's no actually, that's because DNA Kite is playing, so looks like he's going to clear up on me, unless he makes a mistake in a moment. Now it tells you which balls you're going for next, so it's obviously the orange is next, followed by the green, and that was a miss. Stop, 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 stop. So this is me going on, so I can move this anywhere I like, because it is American rules, right? Which is, like, the crazy thing. And it doesn't want to go very carefully, so if I get to there, hit yes, and then hit OK. And then we have the green one is next. Okay. And he sets the ball wherever he likes for his shot, and away we go. Ka-clunk. And he missed. Would you believe it? He missed. So this sets me up for a middle pocket now. Oh no, it doesn't. I'm going to send it down this direction, because otherwise we'll have a problem. We do appreciate the slightly wider pockets. Now. I got it. I actually got it in. More luck than judgment. Now we'll see if we'll be able to slice this one in. Nearly. his turn now, and he should be able to just chip this one in, or slice it in, or whatever the phrase is. Yes, he is, and he's going to win this game as well. But this is cool, and it's really nice to play. It looks really good. It sounds really good, and with a little bit of practice, I'm sure it'll become very good. And I get the chance to win a game here, which is crazy. So, bang. So I've earned a game with no fouls or something. So that gives me a little bit of boost in my XP and all this kind of stuff, which is fine. I don't know how I'm going to use this XP. I don't really care for it all that much. But I do appreciate the fact that I can get in and have a bit of a game. And we'll offer a rematch here. And yes, place the ball because it is my shot. And then now I don't know how you do a power punch here. So we'll just go full back. And we'll open it up to the full, and that means that I think I fouled the ball straight away. So we're going from 1 through to 8. Well, 1 through to 9, actually, isn't it? The rules are in here as well, so we can follow up on all of those rules as soon as I get past the fun of using the cue and getting a feel for this. Number 3 here is going into the corner left pocket, and he has really screwed that up. Keep going, Red, keep going. So, not sure what I'm going to do with this now, apart from punch it. And that looks like it's covered by the green, so that's good. It's going for the 3 ball. Ain't that pretty? He has to go for the 3 ball. What's he going to do with the 3 ball, though? There it is. He's sending it around. And he's putting me up for a snooker. Well, I should be able to get out of that fairly quickly. Oh, yeah, he made it as well. Alright, that's touching the cushion, I hope, so it's going to make it difficult for him to put in. Not that he's not going to try. And he did. The 4 ball now is there. It is slightly compromised. This guy is not too bad, it looks like. Now, I'd love to be able to double, but I think the black is in the way. Well, maybe not. But in any case, I'm not very good at doubling, so I'm not going to. I'm just going to put a shot in like that. God, I could have made that as well, couldn't I? If I'd taken a bit more time. Gah. Now he's doing this. This seems to be the favorite shot no matter what the game is. This punching the cue ball into the cloth and getting it to do some funky spin. That's green is not going to be too difficult. And clearing up from here doesn't look like it's going to be too hard at all. Just roll it in and don't move it away. Or do move it away. That's just, why did he have to go so hard? Okay, this sets me up now for an opportunity myself to clear up. I do get the line there, so I'm assuming that's going to get me in. No, frick. It's all about the angles, and I don't know the angles. God. So the challenge here is quite compelling. Oh, he's failed as well. Whoops. Right, now I need to come all the way down the table for this black next. So I need to put a bit of punch in here. Or do I? I could just reverse it. Couldn't I? And then punch it. Stop, 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 stop. That'll do. Enough of an angle there to take that out. And then I could have done that much harder to bring the ball much further down the table, but I'm not too clever. Okay. He won't be able to get that in. Unless he knows a trick shot that he's able to double it back into a corner or something. Okay, he's just set that up for a shot for me. Now, this would be a long corner, nominating the bottom left corner. This is a slow-mo of my shot. And ba-ding, ba-dang, ba-doom. I think I've won, so win three consecutive games. Did I win three consecutive games? I don't believe I won three consecutive games. I think I lost a number of consecutive games. That's 2-1. How did I win the last one? Oh, I did win the other game, actually. I did. Because he lost at the last minute. So, anyway, there we go. This is it. And if we hit B, then we can get up into free play and we can go and learn our way around the game and we can play... we can play 9-ball, US 8-ball, we can play backball, snooker, we can play killer, and we can play accumulator. These are the game types that are in. Now, the snooker is an add-on DLC. It's an extra $4 or something, and it's, as far as I'm concerned, easily spent. We can also play player 1 versus player 2. We can get into a league, which is something I'll probably do and make a video series about. We have free play where we can just play snooker or whatever we like, and then we can practice offline, again playing snooker, blackball, 9-ball or whatever. And right now I'm in a kind of a free play here, so I can pretty much choose to do what I like and just have a little bit of fun knocking balls in and learning how I'm going. So anyway, this is pure pool and it's not very expensive. Bought it from Steam and it comes in at kind of like 10 euro or something. It's a fairly straightforward game. And I'm quite enjoying it. The fidelity looks very good to me. The controller is, you know, something that I have and I use occasionally, and it's something that I think works quite well for this game. You can play with a mouse as well. I think a lot of people do. 2-for-1. Now we get to see if we can do our slice maneuver here. Oh, we can. Take that off the pocket. And do the same here. And I'm going to put that one in the pocket as well. Another foul. The joy of pool. Ba-toom. Okay, that was full wackadoo. There she goes. And as soon as the pool ball comes to a stop, it'll re-rack and we'll come to a stop. And we'll say that's her. That is pure pool with the snooker on here. I can imagine spending a little bit of time on this game. It is one of the sweetest pool and snooker game experiences that I have. It's just fantastic. Definitely recommend it. Details are below in the description if you're interested. And Mux, this one's just for you. You know why. Until the next time, everybody, thanks and have a good one. Go handy.